I am Dr. W. Kanare from Kamalanidhi Mahavidyalaya Nagpur. Today we are going to discuss another reaction intermediate, that is carbene. And carbene is a chemical species in which the carbon have two electron and two covalent bonds. So like carbonium ion, carbene is also a highly reactive. It is a electrophile and a short lived. And there are two types of carbene, singlet carbene and triplet carbene. And here we are discussing about what is carbene, what are the orbital structure, and what are the types of carbene, and how it is generated, and some and the stability of the carbene. So all these part we are going to discuss today. So today's topic is the mechanism of organic reaction. This is the part number 6, and in this part we are going to discuss the detail about the reaction intermediate carbene. So what is carbene now here? Before going to see all that part, so here the topics covered are carbene, generation of carbene, types of carbene, orbital structures, and the stability of different types of carbene. And so first of all, we should have to know what is carbene. So carbene is a species in which the we can say that carbene have two electrons and the two covalent bonds. For example, C double bond and two electrons are there. Example of this is the methylene, CH2, two electrons. So carbene is highly reactive species. So these are the examples also shown in the slide. So what is carbene? Carbene can be defined as the divalent carbon in which carbon atom is bonded to two monovalent atoms or groups by covalent bond, and has two non-bonding orbital containing two electrons between them, and therefore this is known as the carbene. So carbene have two electrons and two covalent bond. These are also called methylene, because in actual practice parent species, like that is the methylene is known as methylene, but in its derivative commonly known as the carbene. So parent species is the methylene. So this is the example, having this carbon having two electrons and two covalent bond with the hydrogen. So this is the parent species, which is known as methylene. Now here this is CCl2, dichlorocarbene. So derivative of this methylene is known as the carbene. So dichlorocarbene, diphenyl carbene. So these are the examples of carbene. So carbene have two electrons and two bonds and highly reactive species. And these are the examples of the carbene, and we can see that these carbenes are short-lived, highly reactive species. And in this case, central carbon atom have 6 electrons in the valence shell, and therefore it has strong tendency to complete the octet by accepting 2 electrons. So we can see that also carbene behave like a Lewis acid, or it is also a electrophile. So this is about the carbene. So what is carbene? Examples of carbene are given in this slide. And next part is the generation of carbene. How carbenes are generated? So different three methods are there of the formation of this carbene. So first method is by thermal decomposition or by photochemical decomposition of cyclopropane or oxyrene. Two are given here. So this is cyclopropane, phenyl cyclopropane. This is the phenyl, C6H5. Phenyl cyclopropane. This is cyclopropane, phenyl cyclopropane. Now when it is heated, what is then? This bond get break, and these two electrons are shifted here, and this also bond get break and electrons are here. So what is now? C6H5CsCH2, double bond is here, and now this electron pairs are here with this CH2. So this this bond and these two electrons are shifted here. This bond is also, so what is now here? We get this methylene carbene, and this is phenyl ethene. Another example, that is the 1,2 diphenyl oxyrene. This is the compound known as diphenyl oxyrene, and when it is in the presence of sunlight, what is then this bond get back, and what is now C6H5CH, having the two electrons, and this compound is the another compound, what is C6H5CHO. This is C6H5CHO, so another benzaldehyde, and this is phenyl carbene is obtained. So methylene carbene, this is parent, therefore it is known as methylene. And this is the derivative known as the phenyl carbene. another method, that is thermal and photochemical decomposition of the diazo alkane or ketene. These two compound, diazo methane or ketene. So in case of diazo means this nitrogen bonds are here, double bond. So this is called azo, two are there, therefore it is diazo methane. So in case of diazo methane, this bond, one bond get break and electrons are shifted here, so it is negatively charged. And now what is this is similar to this, bond comes here, so it become triple bond. Again from this we obtain, after breaking this bond, CH2 with two electrons are here. This is known methylene or carbene, and this azo, N triple bond N is there, azo compound. So ketene, this is the formula of ketene, CH2CO. This bond get break and here it is shifted, so we get methylene carbene and this is CO. So in this way, by photochemical decomposition of diazo alkane, diazo methane and ketene, we obtain this CH2 and this CH2 methylene carbene. Third method is the by action of strong base, usually potassium tertiary butoxide, on the chloroform. So this is CaCl3 chloroform and this is the butoxide. And here CaC3COH, this bond get break and what is shifted here, and this is another compound is this is formed. And what is now here, we obtain this type of compound. This is unstable carbon, have two electrons and 3 Cl on the same carbon, and therefore this is unstable, and therefore one of the Cl gets this bond get break and Cl chloride ion gets formed. And here what is now, then we obtain this dichlorocarbene in this way. So chloroform, from the chloroform also we obtain first unstable compound and then dichlorocarbene. So these are the three methods of the generation of or the formation of carbene compound. Now there are two types of carbene, and depending upon the distribution of electrons between the two orbitals, carbene are two types. Depending upon the two electrons, what is, as we know, carbene have two electrons. So depending upon the distribution of these two electrons, carbenes are two types, singlet carbene, triplet carbene. In case of singlet carbene, two electrons are present in one orbital, same orbital. In case of triplet carbene, two electrons are present in two different orbitals. So in case of two different orbitals, they have same spin, but when the two electrons are present in case of singlet in one orbital, then they have opposite spin. And therefore the singlet carbenes are diamagnetic, triplet carbene is paramagnetic. So here we can say that in case of a singlet and triplet carbene, so what is singlet carbene? We can say that non-bonding electrons are present in one orbital, that is two electrons are paired and other orbital is empty. The carbene of this type is known as singlet carbene. So again, what is singlet carbene? The singlet carbene in which the electrons are present in one orbital, that is two electrons are paired and the other orbital is empty. Carbene is said to be such type of carbene is known as the singlet carbene. Singlet carbenes such as singlet methylene is represented as the two electron with CH2 and two electrons are opposite spin. Singlet carbene has no unpaired electron and therefore has no dipole moment, and therefore this compound is a diamagnetic in nature. And due to the diamagnetic, it cannot be detected by ESR, that electron spin resonance spectroscopy. It cannot be detected by ESR spectroscopy. Now on the other side, when the two electrons are unpaired and are present in two different orbitals of equal energy with their spin parallel according to Lorentzian, this is known as the carbene, and this carbene is known as triplet carbene. So here is shown what is triplet carbene. So we can say that triplet carbenes are those carbene in which the two electrons are present in different orbitals with the same spin according to Lorentzian, and carbene is said to be a triplet carbene. So triplet carbene, like a triplet methylene, is represented as the two electrons are with the CH2, these two electrons are having the same spin, and therefore we can say that triplet carbene has permanent dipole moment, and therefore triplet carbene has two unpaired electrons, and hence it is a paramagnetic in nature, and therefore it can be easily detected by ESR, electron spin resonance spectroscopy. So this is two types of carbene. One is singlet carbene, second is triplet carbene. And this is shown here, this singlet methylene. See now here, one orbital have two electrons. In case of singlet, both the electrons appeared here, two electrons appeared and position in one orbital, other orbital is vacant, having two bonds. So this is singlet, this is unhybridized p orbital, empty orbital. In case of triplet methylene, two electrons are present separately or unpaired and present in both the orbitals, and therefore there are two unpaired electrons in triplet methylene, and therefore this such type of carbene is known as the triplet carbene. So two types are there, singlet and triplet carbene. Now the orbital picture shows that in case of carbene, in case of singlet carbene, central atom is sp2 hybridized. It is shown in the figure. In case of singlet carbene, this carbon is sp2 hybridized. So here this is the one is the an empty orbital, and this is having the orbital, third orbital have two electrons. So in case of singlet, the central atom is a sp2 hybridized. Two of the sp2 hybrid orbitals are used in forming the two sigma bond with the two monovalent atoms or group, while third sp2 orbital contains two non-bonding electrons, that is lone pair. The unhybridized p orbital is empty. So in case of singlet carbene, it is a bent chemical species, because here in case of singlet, these are the two sigma bond, and this is the one orbital having two non-bonding electrons, and one is an empty orbital. So the singlet carbene is having what is the bent chemical species. On the other hand, we can say that in case of triplet carbene, central carbon atom is sp hybridized. It is shown. This carbon in triplet is a sp hybridized carbon, and two orbitals have single electrons, and two sp have orbital form two sigma bond with two monovalent atoms or group, while two unhybridized p orbital py and pz are perpendicular to each other and contains one electron each. Therefore, triplet carbene is a linear species and behave like a diradical or biradical. So this is about the orbital structures. So singlet and the triplet. So singlet, in which carbon is sp2 hybridized, in case of triplet, carbon is sp hybridized. So this is the structure bent, and this is linear structure. So because these are present in different orbital, so this is the linear and this is the bent like structure of this singlet and triplet carbene. So this is the orbital picture of carbene. And now last is the stability of the carbene. Stability is very important in case of singlet and triplet carbene. So triplet carbene is always more stable. Remember that triplet carbene is always more stable as compared to the singlet carbene. This is because in singlet carbene, two non-bonding electrons are present in the same orbital, and therefore they tend to repel each other. This inter-electronic repulsion increases the energy of singlet state as compared to the triplet state, in which two non-bonding electrons are present in different orbital. Therefore, this supported by the observation that triplet methylene is about 35 kilojoule more stable than singlet methylene. So remember that triplet carbene is more stable as compared to singlet. And also it is observed that carbene in which the central carbon is attached to the two carbon atoms, or two atoms, each one of which has a lone pair of electron, are more stable as compared to the methylene due to the resonance. So if two lone pairs of electrons are present, they show resonance. One example is shown of the such type of example. This one lone pair, second lone pair, and these three lone pairs. So here the two here, so they show resonance, therefore it is more stable as compared to others. So central carbon is attached to the two atom. In that case, each one of the atom has lone pair of electron, and it is more stable as compared to methylene due to resonance. If there is a resonance in any compound, then they are the most stable. So here in case of stability, we have to discuss the stability of triplet carbene or singlet carbene. So triplet carbene is always more stable as compared to singlet carbene, and the reason is that in case of the singlet carbene, two non-bonding electrons are present in the same orbital, and therefore they repel each other, and inter-electronic repulsion increases, and because of that increases the energy of singlet state as compared to triplet state, and therefore singlet state is less stable as compared to triplet state. So triplet state is a more stable as compared to singlet carbene state carbene. So triplet carbene is more stable than singlet carbene. So here we have discussed different aspect about the carbene reaction intermediate. So different reaction intermediate we have discussed. First is the carbonium ion, second carbanion, free radical carbene. So these are the different types of reaction intermediate we have discussed, their generation, and after that some chemical reactions, and different types, and also lastly the stability of all these intermediates. So today we have discussed the carbene. What is carbene? What are the examples of carbene? What are the types of carbene? Methods of generation of carbene, and after that we have seen the orbital structure and stability of carbene. So in case of stability, triplet carbene is more stable as compared to singlet carbene, and so today we stop here, and remaining part also we'll discuss in another lecture.